You're like a robot.
Yeah.
And it's Godot.
We took a look at the current alpha of Godot 4, and it is really interesting what shiny new stuff we will get. The first thing we noticed is that the UI looks quite a bit cleaner overall. Look, it even responds when you hover. The new code font looks slick, and the new colors are also a bit nicer. Let's make a little 2D scene and try out all the new things, and then we'll take a look at the new 3D features. I'm super excited for the new tile map, so let's see if it is really that great. You can go hexagonal, isometric, or even this brick wall shape. I immediately want to make a game with hexagonal tiles. You get this nice preview for the grid, which is lovely. When we add an image to the tile set, it can automatically define the tiles. This will save a lot of time. You can easily map just by selecting one or more tiles and placing them on the screen. I feel just like an RPG maker, which is amazing. It is possible to map on different layers within a single tile map. You can even modulate and y-sort these layers separately. I used to have multiple tile maps, but this is so much cleaner. Finally, tiles can have arbitrary properties. This will make features like step sounds or terrain-based speed very easy. You can paint these properties as well as predefined ones like modulate in a really nice way onto the tiles. Also, defining collisions is so much nicer now. You can define a shape and paint each tile with it. Auto tiles have been replaced with a much better system. You can now define terrains in the property editor and then define what parts of a tile belong to which terrain and just go and map with it. Much faster, more powerful and more intuitive than defining auto tiles. Overall, I am amazed by the new tile map. One of Godot's weaknesses is now one of its strengths. We got a new color picker. That works quite nice. And when we put the modulate over 1 for glow, it stays there, which is a blessing. Gradient textures also have HDR support now. And there's a gradient texture 2D, by the way. Sounds quite awesome. Now 2Ds have a skew property, which is really handy. We used a vertex shader for that kind of stuff before. It's nice to have. When we look at the transform properties, they now have units. You can set canvas items as top level in the editor, so their transform and visibility are no longer affected by their parents. And you can finally pause individual nodes. Thank you. The awaited canvas groups are there, but at the moment they only work when changing the self-modulate, not the modulate. Also, they break when attaching a shader material. Both issues are reported, it's gonna be fixed. A similar feature is clip children, a new canvas item property. It uses the alpha of each pixel for the alpha value of the children canvas items.
Shaders got a really nice default template, which is great because I was kind of annoyed of typing that every time. For 2D lights, we now got directional lights, and you can use a lot of them at once. Particles got a lot of cool stuff. Randomness of properties is handled much better now with a min and a max value. The old randomness behaved really strange sometimes. You can also give particles different starting colors. A thing we noticed is that the frame rate of the editor drops a lot when it's not in focus. I guess this will reduce resource usage, which is neat. Additionally, there are trails now, and they seem quite amazing, especially when combined with sub-emitters. So particles can spawn particles that have trails. I like it. And there are particle collisions, which is amazing. There are shape casts now, which work like ray casts, but for circles and squares and such. Really nice to have. GDScript got a few cool new features. You now can use lambdas and pass functions as arguments. You can even type them as callable and use the call function on them to pass the arguments. This is really useful actually. You can also type arrays. Tweens work pretty different now. They are not nodes anymore. They start automatically and only have 4 parameters. The other parameters you can add with a funny little chain. It will take some time to get used to, but overall this should be much more readable. Yield is now a weight and you reference the signal directly instead of using a string. There's some great new stuff for 3D, which we don't really use all that much, but we will take a look at it regardless. The volumetric fog looks really cool and has a lot of parameters. The glowing ones are really nice too. There are soft bodies now, and you can play around with decals, which are really fun decoration. What is your favorite new feature? Let us know in the comments.
Godot.